New reporting tonight after that horrific story out of Colorado. The pregnant mother and her two young daughters killed. The husband at first, you'll remember, pleading for them to come home. Hours later, reportedly confessing. Well, right here tonight, we're hearing from the last friend to see that pregnant mother alive, the woman who dropped her off at the house. Here's ABC's Clayton Sandell from Colorado again tonight.
As formal charges were filed in a horrific, incomprehensible triple murder, new bombshells.
This afternoon, my office filed formal charges against Christopher Lee Watts.
Court documents revealing Chris Watts' alleged confession in the murder of his pregnant wife and two daughters coming with a bizarre twist.
He was the one for me, and he is amazing.
But according to court documents, a two-day investigation revealed Chris was actively involved in an affair with a coworker. He allegedly tells investigators he told his wife he wanted to separate. But then Chris claims a moment later, he sees Shanann on a baby monitor strangling one of the girls. According to the affidavit, Chris said he went into a rage and ultimately strangled Shanann to death. He says he drove the bodies to a remote oil field. Mm-hmm. Nicole Atkinson, the last friend to see Shanann alive, says later that day, Chris seemed unconcerned his wife and kids were missing.
He just kept saying he didn't know where she was, that she was on a play date, but he couldn't give us the name of the friend.
Atkinson says a neighbor's security camera should have seen them leaving for that play date, but she says the footage only shows Chris driving away in his work truck.
What does that tell you?
That there was something seriously wrong.
That feeling reinforced by Chris's demeanor in TV interviews.
Shanann, Bella, Celeste, if you're out there, just come back.
The more I watched them, the more angrier I got.
Atkinson says Shanann told her Chris had recently been acting strangely. She had suspected an affair.
He wasn't being the loving Chris that he normally was. He wasn't touching or hugging or doing stuff like that.
And Clayton Sandell joined us outside the Watts family home again tonight. And Clayton, Christopher Watts has a court appearance tomorrow. And this comes after the breaking news late today, the charges just revealed.
That's right, David. Watts will be back in court tomorrow to hear these charges for the first time. He has not entered a plea. And in the meantime, you can see this memorial here in front of the family home to Shanann and the girls continues to grow. David.
Clayton, thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.